Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to be talking about circles, and we're going to start by looking at the standard form or the standard equation for a circle, and that's x minus h quantity squared plus y minus k quantity squared is equal to r squared. The center of the circle is defined as h k. Notice how h is near the x variable and k is by the y variable. And the radius is going to be when we take the square root of this value here, r squared, which will give us the radius. The example that we're going to look at, today is x squared plus y squared minus 4x plus 6y plus 12 is equal to 8. As you see, this equation here is not in standard form, so for us to be able to tell what the center is and the radius, we're going to have to change this equation into something that looks more like this standard form. First thing I want to do is go ahead and subtract 12 from both sides. When I do that, I end up with x squared plus y squared minus 4x plus 6y is equal to 8 minus 12, which leaves me with a negative 4. Now I have to use a method called completing the square, and I'm going to do that by first grouping my x's together, x squared and 4x, and then my y's together, y squared and positive 6y. So we'll begin there. X squared minus 4x, I'm going to leave some space here, plus y squared plus 6y, again leaving some space, equal to the negative 4 that we have here. To complete the square, that's a principle where I take this coefficient of the variable that's not squared, in this case negative 4, I'm going to take half of that, and then I'm going to square that number. So here I have negative 4 divided by 2 leaves me negative 2 to the second power, and negative 2 times negative 2 is going to give me a positive 4. So what I'm going to do is add 4 here, and I'm going to also add 4 here, because we know from the rules of algebra what we do to one side we must do to the other. So if I add 4 in one place, I need to add 4 in the other place. On the other side here, dealing with the y variables, I see that this y to the first power has a coefficient of 6, so I'm going to take half of 6 and square that. So 6 divided by 2 is 3, and when I square 3, that equals 9. So I'm going to add 9 here, which means I have to add 9 over here. The reason I did the completing the square is because now I'm able to factor this easier. So this here turns into x minus 2 squared plus y plus 3 squared. Then I evaluate what's over here to the right. Negative 4 plus 4 gives me 0, and that just leaves me with 9. So I know that here the 9 matches the r squared, so I can say r squared equals 9. I take the square root of both sides, and I know that r is equal to 3. So I know that there is my radius. And then as I look for my hk, I see that next to the 2, next to the x, I have a negative 2. So my h is going to be opposite of what I see here. So that's going to be positive 2. And my k is going to be over here, and that should be opposite of what I see. So that there is negative 3, and that there is my center. So here I have a circle that I started off in a form that was not like the standard form. I converted it to the standard form. I use the method called completing the square so that I'm able to factor my x terms and factor my y terms. Once I did that, I was able to come up with the center, 2, negative 3, and then I took the square root of this constant here to figure out what the radius would be. So again, thank you for tuning in to Speller Tutorial Services. Please take a look at our Facebook page and continue to look at us on our YouTube channel under the same name, Speller Tutorial Services. Thank you.